I'm going to jump right on to chapter 8 of the report card because I'm dying to know what happens. This chapter is called Roadkill. There was a dead squirrel in front of the school on Tuesday morning. It had been there a while, and a group of walkers were out on the sidewalk cheering whenever it got run over again by a passing car or a bus. It was not a nice way to start the school day, and it didn't exactly make me feel proud to be a human. In homeroom, Miss Noyes handed me a note. Please report to Dr. Trindler's office immediately after lunch and plan to stay there during 6th and 7th periods, which was lousy news. That was during science and music, two of my favorite classes, and I knew what would be happening, evaluation of me. We had free reading time at the beginning of first period language arts, and Stephen came and sat beside me on the pillows in the reading corner. He held up a book and whispered, I heard about your big meeting yesterday. You did? I asked, how? How? Said Stephen. Because it's all over the school, that's how. I heard that Jenny Ashton was in the nurse's room after school. She saw Miss Byrne take you to the office, and she saw all the teachers, and your mom, and Dad. Everyone knows you got bad grades, too. I guess that's kind of my fault, because I told Ellen, and she told Jenny. Sorry about that. And I'm really sorry you're in so much trouble. Did they yell at you and stuff? Of course they didn't, I said, and I'm not in trouble. Stephen frowned and said, you sure? Because my mom would put me in military school or something, if I even got 1D, let alone a bunch of them. And Jenny said you were crying when you came out of the office and your mom was dragging you by the arm. What? That's a lie. And I said it so loud that Miss Noyes looked up from her book and frowned at me. So I pretended to read until the coast was clear, and then I hissed, no one yelled at all, and no one even came close to crying, least of all me. Ugh, that Jenny Ashton is gonna get it. Stephen needed more proof that I hadn't been tortured in the meeting. He said, so if they didn't yell at you, what did everyone say? Nothing much, I whispered. My mom wanted to know how come she didn't get any warnings about my D's, and the teachers had to explain why I got bad grades. It was all pretty stupid. I got bad grades because I did bad on some tests. Duh. And now they want me to take more tests to see if I'm as dumb as they think I am. But you're not dumb, Stephen said. Even I know that, and I really am dumb. I pushed him on the arm. Don't ever say that, Stephen. I hate it when you say that. He shrugged. Well, you're the one who always says you have to face facts, so face it. I'm dumb. I pushed him again, and that was one too many disturbances. Nora, Miss Noyes was using, her soft reading time voice. Either read quietly, or I will find you some other work and another place to sit. Final warning. I nodded and put my nose in my book, but I whispered to Stephen, bad test grades do not mean you are dumb, and I am not in trouble. And if you see that Jenny Ashton, you tell her to start fixing those rotten rumors before I fix her. When I went to my locker after first period, Charlotte Kendall came up to me. Charlotte wears a different colored ribbon in her hair every day, and she always holds her book and her notebook up tight against her stomach with both arms. She whispered, but Charlotte's whispers carry about 10 feet, so we had an audience. Nora, I heard about your grades, your averages. They must be ruined. What are you going to do? Do you think you're going to get left back? I couldn't stand it if I got left back. I smiled as best I could. It's okay, Charlotte. I won't get left back. I promise. Well, she said, if there's anything I can help you with, just ask me, okay? Because I got almost straight A's, and I really would help you if you wanted, okay? I looked hard at Charlotte, testing for acid in her face or her eyes. Not a trace, only sweetness. Charlotte meant every word, and she wasn't bragging about her grades, just stating a fact. So I smiled and said, oops, my dog is bumping the grits table. And she wasn't bragging about her grades, just stating a fact. So I smiled and said, thanks, Charlotte. That means a lot to me. And it did. Charlotte truly felt bad for me. She helped me remember that as far as everyone else was concerned, I was going through a crisis, an ordeal. Because for everyone else, it was an absolute fact that fifth grade grades mattered. My grades made me look like that dead, Sciurus Carolinus on the road out in front of the school. Oh, that's a Latin name for squirrel, but I don't think I pronounced it right. And in less than 3 hours, Dr. Trindler was going to get out his measuring tools and try to figure out just how flat this squirrel really was.